He's long-suffering. He's abundant in goodness and in truth. Keeping mercy to thousands and forgiving iniquity and transgressions and sin. And that will by no means clear the guilty. Now, what are you saying here? When I was out in the world, everybody told me that God was going to get me. That if he's going to do something terrible toward me. But what God did was he saved my soul. Yes, God is not a God that sit tight wanting to zap you for your wrongdoing. He's a God that wants you to have a relationship with him.
Yeah.
In Genesis 18:14, the Lord was talking to Sarah. And he said, is there anything too hard for the Lord? Yeah. And he said, at the time I appoint, I will return unto thee, and according to the time of life, and Sarah will have a son. God got an appointed time that he will pour out his manifold blessings in your life. In Jeremiah 32:17, when Jeremiah's in the court of the prison, and he told Jeremiah to go ahead and buy the land, and Jeremiah said, there is nothing too hard for God.
Amen.
Jeremiah 32:27, God said, is there anything too hard for me? Someone's right now in some difficult situation, but I guarantee you, if you turn it over to God, there's nothing too hard for God.
Amen.
In Matthew 19:26, Jesus said, with men this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. In Luke 1:37, the angel of the Lord named Gabriel spoke to Mary, and he said, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. Amen. When they was leaving David, they came to David and told David that his son Absalom was starting the ruckus. And David said, the Lord is my shepherd. They say he got some of your counsels. And David said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Amen.
David said that he's going to run you out of town. And as David was leaving out of town, he said that the Lord is my shepherd. If the Lord sees so, he will bring me back.
Amen.
That's what he's saying. If you know that the Lord is your shepherd, he'll bring you back.
Amen.